middle of the road about Shamokin. I grew up, I'm 48 years old. I lived in Elysburg, and I moved here about 3 years ago. To me, Shamokin went downhill in a time of span that I known in the area. And I don't think it'll ever be back to the same level that it was once.
Hi, my name's Shane Hart. Here to talk about Shamokin, I guess. It's not a bad town, honestly. Just the job market around here ain't too good.
No.
Not at all. Sucks. And there ain't too much to do for the younger kids around here.
No.
There honestly isn't. I think there needs to be more community between the town, honestly.
Yeah.
Like more block parties and stuff. Yeah. And more outreach for the younger kids, I honestly do.
And the young kids need to get off the drug.
Yeah. That's what I'm
So yeah, I love Shamokin. I live in York now, and I come up, see old friends. Just the scenery is beautiful, the mountains beautiful. I love it. But you know, this is not without its flaws. I think it's a great town. We still got work to do. There's a lot of people. You know, I got friends that are interested in parties and politics and whatever. I don't get into it too much, which you know I should. You know, it comes down to community. If you know, you need a strong community. If you don't have a strong community, then you're a weak town. Yeah. And that's the direction every town's going. Yeah. You're so focused on finances, and you know, you forget. You know, just enjoy the day, simple things, and you know, family and good friends. And if you don't have that, just keep looking, man. It's not easy. As you get older, you learn. You gotta bring communities together. That's what we do.
A century or two ago, we built our church and marked the common out. We raised the town hall next, so we could have our say about the taxes, or whether we need another teacher for the school. When town meeting comes around, we know our rights and duties, and no harm if we disagree. In all that matters, we neighbors hold together. We work from sun to dark, if you can call just work a job that helps make a body feel at peace while doing it, or hum a bit with pleasure when it's done. Art isn't something foreign we look at in a showcase. It's in the blankets that we've spun and woven right at home. It's in the patchwork quilt sewn by our daughters at a quilting bee for someone's bridal chest. It's in the locks and hinges that the blacksmith shapes. It's in the baskets that are woven in the neighborhood to fit our household needs, from marketing to mending. When water wheels are better fitted to do the work than human hands, we rig up the machines to saw the wood or grind the corn for hominy grits and johnny cake. A while ago, that corn was on the stalk, above the pumpkins, ripe and yellow. One night the neighbors met to shell ears together. They did the job in no time so they could clear the old barn floor and choose their favorite partners for the dances. There was lasting harmony between the soil and what we built or planted there. We used our hands and mastered what we laid our hands on. Working and living, we found a balance. The town was us, and we were part of it. We never let our cities grow too big for us to manage. We never pushed the open land too far away. We youngsters took it in, the haying field, the mill, the daily chores, were teachers. We old ones had good years of family life, our own, our children's. Mellow years before the ripe fruit fell, as fruit will drop on windless autumn days. And that was peace. The seed was ready for the earth again, ready to die, ready once more to grow.
I kind of don't like it here.
But I think that it's really important to stay close to family, especially while the kids are young. So that's why we're here. It's still a place where I can leave my keys in my car at night, and I really don't have to worry much about crime, although we have our problems, as we found out the other night, right? It's like a place where people come because you can get easy welfare benefits and easy housing benefits, and there's a lot of lower, I don't want to say lower class people, but okay, I said it, and I'm not really, but they're still good people, you know. There's something about the coal region that it's like a quality of helpfulness, like good-natured people that you run into. I don't go to a lot of big cities, so I don't know if you find the same kind of people there. People are sort of, coal region people are friendly.
So yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Because my shit goes, I mean, there's a lot of, not like hardcore crime, but there's crime around here. Some of it's hardcore, but not really. There's not too many people about that life. That's another thing. They have a lot of places around, well, not only in Shamokin, but around here, they have a lot of places you can go riding at, so I like to ride. The people, like I said, most of them are laid back, but these people are probably weirdos around here. That's about it. There's a few assholes around here.
It's not that big of a hill.
A lot of ugly chicks too.
Don't get in there very often. I don't have a car and I can't walk very far, so once in a while one of my sons will take me into the bank and that's it. So I don't get to know Shamokin what it's like today, that is. I always liked it years ago. When they had the movies and stuff, when I was a young girl. Yeah. Now I'm 88 and it makes no difference to me what goes on in town anymore.
It's an alright town.
It's pretty cool. There's some stuff to do, but not a lot.
Drugs. The drugs.
Yeah.
Go.
Most of them. Get rid of them.
I love the town. There needs to be some industry, I think. More jobs. That's what I think. There's a lot of good hardworking people, but there's nothing for them to do. You can't be a hard worker and have no work. But I love the town. I lived here for 25 years now.
Looks bad for the town. They're in trouble money-wise. And hopefully they'll get out of it with this Act 47. The government gives them money to get them out of the hole. So that's that might help in the end. Well, the only thing I know is that the state gives them the state is going to give them over $1 million to cover some of their debt that's been accumulating over, I would say, the last 10 years because of bad politicians. And hopefully that'll get them out of it. That's all I can tell you about that. I don't know that much. You'd have to talk to a politician about that, you know.
Shamokin is really just a boring place. There's some things to do, but not really much. I would like to go visit other places more than here. That's really all I have to say.
And believe me, I came here from Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, that I've got to be back in the city. There's nothing here, no jobs, no nothing. So, it's a nice place to visit, but not to live. That's all I got to say.
I've been here in Shamokin living for a while. People are nice. Things change. Cops are still not doing their job like they're supposed to. I ain't afraid to say nothing, you know, if I'm gonna be on paper or whatever, hey. Thanks for your time. See you later.
Average day. I get up, I have a cigarette, I eat breakfast, I have coffee, I have another cigarette, I watch TV. And then I do a little bit of chores, and then I cook. Then I hang out back, because we have a bird feeder and stuff like that, so I like watching that in the bird feeder. Well, they need a lot more jobs, and it's all right. I like the people that are in it. But like my neighbors here, everybody, we all get along, and it's good to go. Other than that, we do need the jobs. People on too much welfare. That's about all I can think of.
Better, but you know, you could use more improvement as far as people go. I mean, the people that are living there now are the people that tend to be there for years. But the new generation coming in tends to be somewhat from other areas. It's a good place, ethnic, as far as its history goes. It's a coal mine area. It's not a bad area to be in.
I told him about that Act 47. The government's gonna loan the money.
Oh, they'll never get it back.
No, that's for sure.
This is a lost cause here. All little towns are.
Yeah, the governor Corbett, he screwed the whole Pennsylvania.
Don't tell us that this is the best that you can do in building cities. Who built this place? What put us here? And how do we get out again? We're asking. Just asking. We might as well stay in the mills and call that home. They're just as fit to live in. We mine the coal, load the furnace, roll the steel, drive the rivets. We lock the bolt on the assembly line. Lucky if we have the chance to keep the job from day to day, from month to month.